everyone. We are not good at speaking English, but we will try our best. Recently, the number of science teachers has been decreasing due to declining birth rate in Japan. And science has become less popular among children. So, we need to encourage children to get interested in science. Next, new national guidelines of study at elementary and junior high school introduce environment and energy education. Also, after the 2011 Tohoku earthquake, we need to think about the future Japanese energy program considering the global environment. In this context, it is very important to educate children who hold the future of Japan in their hands and to improve their consciousness to environment and energy. So, as a material of off-campus learning classes, if we have developed power generation mechanisms and electrical storage system of renewable energy. As teaching materials, we have made three experiment devices. First, the understandable experiment of the mechanism of power generation. Second, window power generation and storage of electricity using plastic bottle propeller. Third, the experiment of electrical storage system using hydrogen storage alloy. First experiment, we confirm current reaction of galvanometer by moving considerable of copper, iron, aluminum, and so on, and magnet battery. This experiment is electromagnetic induction, so-called Fleming through. Next, we will show how to make turbine used in this experiment. This is process of make a turbine. This picture is the finished product. This slide shows process of experiment using turbine. At first, we set the turbine and put the magnet under the turbine. And we rotate the copper wire turbine by drawing electric current. Next, take out the battery and connect to the galvanometer instead. If we rotate the turbine, the needle on the galvanometer swings. This confirms current flowing, that is power generation. Through this experiment, we can understand how to generate power at a window power station and thermal power station. Next slide shows our ideas when we carry out this experiment. First, our idea is to change length of another end of copper wires and make a map of a cardboard in advance. This makes the experiment easier for elementary school students. The next idea is to make of a battery case made of scrap materials. This considers global environment. Third idea is to lithium magnet in a plastic case. This prevents injury due to the strong lithium magnet. The fourth idea is to prepare floating blue tubes and attach the both ends of each copper wires. This makes a hexagon 7 tubes and prevents the connect between copper wires. Please have a look at this picture. This device has copper plastic bottle, motor synchronizing, capacitor, and music box. Next, the figure is for circuit using capacitor and diode. Now, we explain how to carry out this experiment. First, condition of a switch off Music box was playing only while the propeller was rotating. When we stopped the rotation of the propeller, music box was also stopped playing. Next, condition of switch on. Music box was playing while the propeller was rotating. Even when we stopped the rotation of the propeller, music box kept on playing for a while. This result shows the importance of storage of electricity. Here are our ideas when we carry out this experiment. First, we made a propeller with a plastic bottle. This enabled us to attach any plastic bottle regardless of our manufacturer. Second, we can generate electricity by burning propeller. So, everybody generates electricity easily. Third, we connect diode to the circuit of the stored electricity. We prevent a backward flow of electricity.
Please have a look at this figure. This figure shows the circulation of energy in this experiment. We use the water, which is occurred in the reaction process of the fuel cell for electrolysis of water. Therefore, we don't have to waste anything, and the device is simple and small scale. So we think that the device can be easily introduced at home, and can be used forever in theory. This slide shows the process experiment. At first, we generate electricity by solar power or wind power. We carry out electrolysis of water. Then, we accumulate hydrogen in the syringe and dry it. We use P2O5 in this process. Next, we introduce dried hydrogen in the hydrogen storage alloy with pressure. Next, put pressure on syringe. We humidify hydrogen and send hydrogen to the fuel cell. This is how we generate electric energy from hydrogen and oxygen. This slide shows feature of this device. First feature is dry hydrogen using P2O5. Second feature is to accumulate hydrogen into syringe. The third feature is that hydrogen can be accumulated into a small state. The problem for the practical use is developing a transmission field that can only detect hydrogen. There are our ideas to carry out this experiment. At first, we using P2O5 to dry hydrogen. This makes the experiment safer and speed dehumidification. Using P2O5 also prevents degradation of hydrogen storage alloy. Second feature is accumulation of hydrogen into syringe. It clearly shows the amount of hydrogen. This picture is seen of off-campus classes. After the off-campus classes, we asked to fill in a questionnaire to students, their parents, and elementary school teachers. Take a look at this pie chart. First question is about the content of the classes. 98% of the students replied that the content was good. The second question is whether the students under the content or not. 98% of the students gave a positive reply. The third question is whether the classes help to improve the knowledge and consciousness to environment and energy. All students answered yes to this question. Here are some comments from participants. I really want to participate again if there is a chance, said an elementary school student. I could understand this off-campus classes more than experiment at junior high school, said a junior high school student. Apparently, we could experience the thing we cannot easily experience, even though it is close to our daily life. A elementary school teacher said, it is very rare that elementary school students focus for such a long time. These questionnaires prove that our experiments have high educational effect and raise the students' consciousness to environment and energy. For the parent, it is expected that our experiment gives the start of making an effort to save energy at home. We feel progress of independence, creativity, ability of suggest issue, ability of solution, and ability to project management. We sum up our presentation. Therefore, we believe that there is high possibility to put this small-scale electrical storage system to practical use in the future. Finally, we will do an experiment about energy efficiency from now on. Thanks very much for listening.
ありがとうございました。さて、ただいまは水素吸送合金を用いた再生可能エネルギーの蓄電システムの開発、小中学校の出前授業教材として新居浜工業高等専門学校の皆さんでした。それでは次、冒頭でございます。ご質問のございます方、手を挙げてお知らせください。どうぞ。ではあちらでマスクをされている男性の方にご質問をお願いしたいと思います。
発表ありがとうございます。質問で新野さんの水素吸送合金に水素を吸着させるっていうところで、具体的にどういった金属を、なんか複数種類あるみたいなんですけど、それで一体具体的にどういうものを使ったかっていうのを教えていただけないでしょうか。
ご質問ありがとうございます。今回私たちが実験で用いた水素吸送合金はニッケル系の金属を使用したキャニスターとして市販されているものです。
ありがとうございます。
そしてご質問のほど、お隣の方も挙手されてましたでしょうか。ご質問ございますかな、お手を挙げてお知らせください。大丈夫でしょうか。ただいまはオーダルプレゼンテーション9、水素吸送合金を用いた再生可能エネルギーの蓄電システムの開発、小中学校の出前授業教材として新居浜工業高等専門学校の皆さんでした。どうもありがとうございました。